are in Parashat Shoftim, very appropriate parasha for the beginning of Elul, where it teaches us a few basic things of how to really guard myself from failing. Besides that, the whole idea of Shoftim means judges, and it says Shoftim v'Shotrim, you should appoint judges and officers to all your gates. If you know how to appoint judges and officers to your gates, your physical gates, then you are guarded from all evil. We have seven gates to our body: two eyes, two ears, two nostrils, and a mouth. These are the gates that I have to appoint judges to judge. Should I look at this? Should I not? Should I listen to this? Should I not? Should I say what I'm about to say, or should I keep quiet? You know how to put judges on the gates, then nothing comes in. Nothing that's not supposed to, nothing goes out that's not supposed to, and so forth. But nevertheless, then there's a part in the beginning of the parasha that gives us a few warnings. And the first thing that it says, lo tate mishpat, don't distort judgment. Lo tate mishpat, lo takir banim. This is going on, it's the prohibition here is for a judge, that if I'm a judge, not to take favor into somebody else, not to take bribery and so forth. But nevertheless, the next thing that it's talking about is lo tikach shochad, don't take bribery. So of course, in one way, this is not so clear, because how many judges do we have in our nation? One out of 100,000 will be a judge, out of 1,000,000. How many judges do we have? I understand that Torah needs to warn everybody, but here it seems like the Torah is warning only judges. Now, I don't think I'm ever going to be a judge. Maybe. I don't know what Hashem is planning. But how many of us become judges? But obviously, if the Torah is already talking towards the judge, then it's talking about the judge in me. I also have to be a judge. I have to judge situations. Exactly like I said before, if you appoint judges to your gates, then you have to judge the situation. Should I look at this thing right now, or should I not? That's being judgmental. And of course, you have to be an honest judge. So in the beginning it says, lo tate mishpat, lo takir panim, don't distort the trial, don't listen to false witnesses and so forth. But we're going to concentrate on the part that it says, velo tikach shochad, don't take bribery. Because even me, not being a judge, I can take bribery. How do you take bribery? If I now judge a situation, and let's say I'm about to do a sin, and I'm about to do something wrong. Now my good judge will tell me, don't do it. It's prohibited in the Torah. Now where do I take bribery? When the Yetzirah says, it's okay, you're doing good. Well, one little sin, what's the big deal? One time. The Yetzirah is coming and bribing you. It will be nice. Don't worry, nobody will catch you. Nobody will see you. So I'm taking bribery from the Yetzirah, and then I'm not being the right judge. But nevertheless, let's see what the Ben Ish Chai says. And he says as follows, Matzinu beperek kama de'avot, in Tractate Avot, in the Mishnah, in Mishnah Bet, it says as follows, Shimon HaTzadik Omer, Shimon, the righteous man, used to say, Ashlosha dvarim ala omed. On three pillars the world stands. Ala Torah, on learning Torah and performing the mitzvot. Ala Avodah, Avodah means prayer. Val gemilut chasadim, and acts of kindness. These are the three pillars that the whole world is standing on. Comes a big question. V'kashe, lama amar chasadim lashon rabim. Why when he says acts of kindness, he said it plural. Gemilut chasadim, should be gemilut chesed. Gemilut chesed means acts of kindness or charitable acts. But he says gmilut chasadim, many, many chasadim. Why plural? Hava lelemeimar, should have said chesed, one chesed. Torah, avodah, v'chesed. Torah means learning Torah and performing the mitzvot, or obeying the mitzvot, fulfilling the mitzvot. Avodah means prayer, and gmilut chesed, I'm doing chesed, I'm doing acts of kindness. Ach hakavana, the reason is, כדי לעשות לכיסא ארבע רגליים. A chair needs four legs. A table needs four legs. Nothing can stand stable on three legs. There are some tables that have three legs, but they're not so stable. But specifically a chair, needs four chair, nor four legs. So he says you need four legs for the chair. Shachesed u'shnei minim. Chesed is two legs. If you're imagining now a chair, and you need to sit comfortable on a chair, so you need four legs. One leg, we said Torah. One leg will be avodah, prayer. And chesed is two legs. Why? Echad gemilut chasadim begufo. One thing is when you do acts of kindness is with your actual body. You take somebody, you help somebody, you carry something, you sit and listen to somebody for half an hour, whatever it is, you do it with your body. Ve'echad gemilut chasadim b'mamono, and the other one is with your money. Because your money, it's very, you can write a check, and in our generation, you can swipe a credit card. I can give a donation on the other side of the world. I don't even know who I gave it to. So when it's doing with my body, I know exactly what I'm doing. I'm now carrying the boxes for this old lady. I'm now going and helping somebody when they're sick, whatever it is. And the other part is money. So chesed, kindness, has two legs, two ways of doing it. One with my body, one with my money. Ach, but Rabban Shimon ben Gamliel besof haperek amar, and then the same chapter in the Mishnah, a different Tana, Shimon ben Gamliel says, al shlosha dvarim ha'olam kayam. The world is existing because of three things. Here, the first part of the Mishnah, Shimon HaTzadik says, ha'olam omed, the world is standing on three pillars. Ben Gamliel says, the world is existing because of three things. What are these three things? Al-Hadin, on judgment. Al-Ha'emet, on truth. Va'al-Shalom, and on peace. So we have judgment, we have truth, and we have peace. Now comes another question. Rekashe. Uma ba lechadesh al Shimon HaTzadik. Rabban Shimon Ben Gamliel is coming to add on Shimon HaTzadik? Shemeila lo, kvar shlosha dvarim yekirim likum olam. Because Shimon HaTzadik already said that we have already three precious things to exist to the existence of the world. Thank you. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, shehakol nehiya v'daro. Ma ba lechadesh al Shimon HaTzadik? What is Rabban Shimon Gamliel trying to add? Shemeila lo kvar shlosha dvarim yekirim likum olam. We already have three things to exist in the world. So it says as follows. The Ben Ish Chai says, ufirashti, and I have explained. Shimon HaTzadik ka'el ha-shamayim de'olam hazeh. Shimon HaTzadik is referring to the heavens, or more precise to say, the firmament of this world. Ve'lachen amar gemilut chasadim. So he said gemilut chasadim, acts of kindness in a plural. Many acts of kindness. כדי לעשות ארבעה רגליים, in order to make four legs for the heavens to sit well on the earth. כי השמיים, לרוב מעלותו, לא הספיק לו שלושה להקימו, אלא צריך ארבעה. The heavens that are, so to say, sitting on the earth, and it's the heavens are like a majestic, the heavens are Hashem's creation, it's not enough for the heavens to sitting on three pillars, it needs four pillars. Ach, Rabban Shimon ben Gamliel, but when Shimon ben Gamliel is talking about, Ayri ba'olam ha-shafel shu ha-eretz ha-tachtona. He's talking about this lower world, which is degraded, it's low, and it's the lower world. Ve'lo yaspik shlosha raglayim. And for her, for the lower world, three legs is enough. So for the heavens, it needs four legs to hold. The four legs, imagine a chair, because it says, ha-shamayim ha-dom raglayim. The heavens is where the Kadosh Baruch Hu, so to say, sitting on the heavens, and he puts the legs on the land, like, you know, these fancy chairs that you sit on the chair, but you have like a little stool to put your legs on. So it says Hashamayim, Shamayim Kisi, the heavens are my chair, Ve'aretz Adom Raglav, the land is like this little stool that the Kadosh Baruch Hu puts his feet on. So the heavens are majestic, so they need four chairs to hold the heavens. Therefore, then Shimon HaTzadik says, no, you need four chairs, four legs, the Torah, the Avodah, and Gemilut Chasadim, both the Chasadim, the acts of kindness with my body and with my money. But Rabban Shimon ben Gamliel says, no, I'm talking about the world below,
It's a low world, olam shafel, and here it's enough three legs. Not only that, he says, "V'katavti, I have written b'makom acher, in a different place." This can be found in a book called Bnayahu, talking about drush of Rosh Hashanah. If you want to go to the reference, he's giving us a reference, chapter 10, page 10, side B. De'al ele romzim shtei shinim shebatfilim shenarosh. What we just spoke about, we have, I don't know if you notice, we have two shins on the tefillin of the head. Look now at Doron, look at his sides, he has shin here and a shin here. See, you can look at both he's wearing tefillin, and you can see there's a shin on each side. So he says here, the Ben Ish Chai, that this concept that we're talking about, the heavens and the earth, is hinted in the shin that's on the tefillin of the head. Because on the tefillin of the hand, there's no letters. It's completely clean. The tefillin of the head, they have a shin on each side. I don't know if you noticed, but I'm happy he's wearing the tefillin. Look at one side. It's four parts of the shin. And the other side is three parts of the shin. Right? I don't know if you ever noticed it. The right side has a shin like this, and the left side, which I'm saying left like as if the tefillin is that way, okay, not this way. So on the right side, a shin is like that, and on the left, the shin is like that. It's four. Why you have four arms there? So see, it's good that he's wearing the tefillin. So he says as follows. Veleka, you never noticed that? A lot of people notice, how come the shin, one shin has four and the other shin has three? Where did you see a shin with four hands? It's pretty rare. Nevertheless, so he says as follows, ולכך, אחת ארבעה קווין, כנגד שלושה של שמעון הצדיק. You have here, one has four קווים, four lines. This is corresponding to Shimon HaTzadik. Torah, Avodah, Gmilut Chasadim, Chesed, kindness with my body, kindness with my money. Right? Shehem Kiyum HaShamayim. This is how the heavens are sitting on the world. You know, if you have a beautiful ceiling, the ceiling is worthless if there's no pillars to hold it. In order to hold the ceiling, you need pillars. So we have pillars holding the Shamayim, the heavens. So according to Shimon HaTzadik, these four pillars that are holding the Shamayim, right? So again, Torah, Gmilut Avodah, and Gmilut Chasadim. This is what's the existence of the heavens. V'hem bechinat arba'ah. So they're coming in a form of four. Ach shin, the tlat reshin. But the other shin that has three hands. Keneged shlosha denakit Rabban Shimon ben Gamliel. That's corresponding to what Rabban Shimon Gamliel says. That there's only three legs that the world is sustaining on. And which were din, emet, and shalom. Right? Judgment, peace, and truth and honesty. ולפי זה, and according to this, צריך האדם להזדרז לקיים השלושה דברים הרמוזים בשין שימין. First of all, you have to be very diligent and very quickly to make sure that you're doing the first three shins. You have to have the right judgment. Now, the right judgment is not only towards myself, it's also how I judge another person. The Mishnah says, "Le'olam al tadin et chavercha." Never judge a person al she'tamod bimkomo, till you stand in his place. It's very easy to look at the person and says, "Look how he's behaving. Look what he just did. Disgusting!" But put yourself in his place. Let's see how you will behave. Besides, it's very easy to throw judgments toward another person, but when I'm in that situation, suddenly I want mercy and I want people to look at me completely different. So the first of all has to be din in the world, has to be judgment. And on the other hand, I have to have a judge in me. Don't do that. My yetzer hara will constantly bribe me. By the way, in case you didn't know, I don't know how about your yetzer hara. My yetzer hara is very corrupt. Constantly is bribing me. Yeah, it's okay, you can do that. It's fine. You're doing a lot of good. You did a few mitzvot today. You can do some sins today. It's okay, Hashem loves you. So the yetzer hara will bribe you constantly. So the world has to stand on din, because if there's no judgment, if there's no good judge, you know, it's even a saying in English, you have to use good judgment. So this is the first leg, this is din. The next one, of course, is emet. Without emet, without truth, there's not going to be, nothing can sustain in this world. And the third one, of course, is peace. Without peace, you know, the Kadosh Baruch Hu created the Torah only to bring peace to the world. Without peace, it's not only peace between the and one nation to the other, or between a husband and wife. Sometimes it's between peace between you and yourself. Most people, they don't have peace inside of them. Shalom can be also hello, but shalom is peace. I want to live in peace. It's called menuchat hanefesh. I want to be calm. I don't want to have anger and anxiety and so forth. But nevertheless, let's just repeat what he says. Lefi ze tzarich ha'adam leizdarez. According to this, one should be very diligent and very strong with fulfilling the three things that are hinted in the shin that is called the klat reishin, that has three heads. And what are these? These are the din, judgment, emet, truth, and peace, shalom. And this is hinted in the right shin, right? V'ashlosha dvarim haremuzim b'shin shel smol. And depending how you're looking at the tefillin. Right now, when I'm looking at the tefillin, it's on the left. If I'm wearing the tefillin, it's on the right. Okay? V'laze amar kan. I'm just saying that you're not going to confuse. The shin, when the tefillin is on my head, the three has to be on the right and the four has to be on the left. That's how it works. If I'm looking at the tefillin now, so the four is on the right and the three is on the left. No, I said it wrong in the beginning. When I'm wearing it on me, the three has to be on my right. Yeah, okay. So I said it right. Nevertheless, lazeh, now to conclude, velazeh amar kan, that's why he says, lo tikach shochad. Don't take bribery. Why did he say shochad? Now look at this, is already the pearls of the Ben Ish Chai. Shochad means bribery. But shochad, how do you write shochad in Hebrew? Shin, chet, dalet. No, how you write in the Torah. Not with the vav. Vav is how maybe we write it. In the Torah, in our parasha, it's written shin, chet, dalet. Saying in other words, shin, chad. Shin, klomar, ma sheramuz b'shin echad, ולא מה שרמוז בשתיהם שהם שלושה וארבעה. You have to go what's hinted in the shin echad, in the first shin, and not what is hinted in both, because then you're going to have seven arms. You have to go by the first shin. The shin chad, shochad, is in the first. You know, you go down to the depth of what he's saying. We have two shins here, right? The first shin corresponds to Shimon HaTzadik. This is the left shin, where you have Torah, Avodah, and Gmilut Chasadim. But we have Rabban Shimon ben Gamliel, who says, no. The world is standing on the three legs of Din, of truth, and peace. So when it says, Lo tikach shochad, don't take bribery, he says the hint here is not the four-handed shin, the three shin. Shin chad, shochad is shin chad, the first shin, right? The first shin that has the three arms. ולא מה שרמוז בשתיהם, and not what it's hinted on both of them, שהם שלוש וארבע, because then it changes the numbers. It's three and four, becomes already seven. So you see the game in the naming is shochad. If you write it with a vav, we'll have a different meaning. But he writes it in this parasha. If you look in the parasha, we just read it now in the morning, so the shochad is written without the vav. So you have shin chad, the first shin. This is where you can't... The first one has three, because the first one is the right one. It has the three shinim, and what are these three shinim? The din, it has emet, and shalom. So this is where you can easily be bribed. When it comes to judgment, you can be bribed. When it comes to truth, you can easily distort the truth. And when it comes to peace, they pretend. Some people pretend that they're in peace. No, you're not. You're not really doing peace here. When it comes to Torah, avodah, and gmilut chasadim, you can be bribed here. You either do it or you don't. But when it comes to din, to emet and shalom, it's very easy to distort it. Now that's why, according to the lower part of the world, this is what runs the world, the lower part of the world. The world above is already Torah, Avodah, Gmilut Chasadim. So this is very appropriate now at the time of the beginning of Elul, when we need to do tshuva. I told you yesterday, the process of tshuva, you have to be judgmental on yourself. If you remember the class yesterday, so first of all, you have to judge yourself. Where am I doing good, and where am I doing wrong? Now, in order for it to work, then it has to be emet. You can't lie to yourself. You want to lie to me, you're welcome, but you can't lie to yourself. If you lie to yourself, you're a fool. And if you think you can lie to Hashem, you're even a bigger fool. So a lot of people lie to themselves for whatever reason. They sugarcoat things, they sweeten things. Don't, if you need to lie, chas v'shalom, not that I'm promoting any type of lying, but if you chas v'shalom need to lie, at least don't lie to yourself. That's living in denial. And a lot of people lie to themselves, so they're not able to really bring themselves to do real tshuva. Now, of course, when it comes to the real tshuva, you remember on Shabbat I told you we had to do a few things. Recommended, not have to, but recommended. The first five was to actually read from books, but the sixth one was to pray for somebody else, and the most important is to forgive every person that did something bad to you. So to bring real peace is you can tell a person, I forgive you, but inside you don't. The real peace is that it's emet, that you really look at the person and you come to the realization the person is just a messenger, he didn't do anything, that person just came as the stick. You know, David HaMelech says, Shivtecha o Mish'antecha hema inachamoni. Shivtecha, Shevet, is a stick. Mish'enet, I don't know, I never found the word in English, maybe you can help me, this thing, this is a Mish'enet. The back part of the chair is a Mish'enet, is where I lean on. So if you have a stool, you have nothing to lean on, you lean back, you fall. But a chair has a Mish'enet, where Nish'anim, I don't know, I never found a good word in English. But what is this we'll call the leaner? Support. The back of the chair. There's not real specific word. In Hebrew it's called Mish'enet. Nevertheless, David HaMelech says, Shivtecha, your stick, Mish'antecha, and your Mish'enet, what I lean on, Hema Inachamuni. I get comfort from both when Hashem I can lean on Him, and also when Hashem hits me. Also when Hashem hits me, it should be comfort to me, because Hashem is putting me back in order. But nevertheless, I said that so many times, if you now go and attack a dog with a stick, then you'll see that the dog will bite the stick. He's not going to bite you, because the dog doesn't understand that you are the one who is throwing the stick. He thinks, he sees the stick hitting him, so he bites the stick. Same thing here. Somebody comes and insults you. Somebody comes and slanders your name. Somebody comes and talks bad about you. Somebody sues you, whatever. You're upset now at the stick. Why are you upset at the stick? You don't understand the Kadosh Baruch Hu is sending him. What don't you understand here? So you are not only that you don't understand that it's Hashem that's sending you, you're now upset at an innocent person. Now I can't necessarily say maybe innocent, but nevertheless, Hashem chose this person to be the Shaliach. Now of course the person has free will, he could choose to do it or not, but nevertheless, why are you upset at the Shaliach? Why are you upset at the messenger? Because he bought you a letter you're not happy about. Go to the ones who send it. That's why real peace is that you look at an individual and you're saying that individual is literally just a tool. It's a tool of the Kadosh Baruch Hu. This is the staff. Kadosh Baruch Hu is hitting me. I should find comfort that the Kadosh Baruch Hu is hitting me. You know, not too long ago, a person said something in public. It was a big group, and he said something that was directed to me to insult me. And in the first few seconds, the feeling was I was insulted. And it was embarrassing, a lot of people looking. But very quickly, Baruch Hashem, my sensors were working well. And I was like, Baruch Hashem, thank you. I was thanking, not out loud, thanking to Hashem, thank you that you're putting me in this situation that I can feel a little bit humble and not to let my ego grow too much. It was a lot of people, and you know, very easy the ego can come and say, look, I'm so special. So Kadosh Baruch Hu right away gave me a smack on the head. Okay, you're not that great. You know, I was thinking about it now in the morning. And if you notice, in the third Aliyah, how many mistakes I made in the Kriya? Four mistakes, right? Four mistakes in the pronunciation of the word. Now, this is where the Kadosh Baruch Hu gives you a smack to the ego. You're not that great. Because, you know, you come sometimes with a lot of confidence. Confidence is very good. But the Kadosh Baruch Hu sometimes confuses the words in your mouth. So, you know, for a Baal Koreh, for the person who's reading from the Torah, to make a mistake, it's embarrassing. What? You don't know how to say the word? Now, it's very easy when you're looking at the book, it's very easy to get the words right. But when you're not, So very easy to get confused. But I know when the Kadosh Baruch Hu is giving me a smack to my head. Because how do I know that? Because the initial feeling is embarrassment or shame or anger or frustration. Then right away I use my mind as saying Hashem is this is the Shivtecha. Then I have to find comfort in that. The Kadosh Baruch Hu is maybe hitting me right now. And of course I can get upset. Usually what people do is they find who to blame. They start screaming at somebody. What did I do? I didn't do anything. What are you screaming at me? Somebody has to be the Sa'ir La'azazel, the one who gets the stira. This is called the Shin Gimel. Somebody has to get somebody has to be blamed. Shin Gimel is the guard in the base in the army. When somebody has to be blamed, they blame the guard. What did I do? I just stand here. Now then, somebody has to get the blame. But Kadosh Baruch Hu uses a lot of tactics how to align you. If you're smart, then you see those tactics. If you're less smart, I don't want to use not nice words, then you don't see that and you get upset. Who do you get upset? At the person in front of you. Why do you want to get upset at the person in front of you? Accept it that it's coming from the Kadosh Baruch Hu. So real peace is when I come to terms that, you know, that I'm not always 100% right. Yesterday when we started the whole tshuva process, the classes, we are going to get to one of the classes where I analyze situation that I got hurt to see if maybe I was the one actually that was wrong here. And you'll find that at least half of the times in the situation that you feel that you are the misfortunate, you're the one to blame. You're the one that could have backed off. You're the one who initiated the argument. You're the one who provoked the other person. So now you're complaining? Why are you complaining now? So nevertheless, so we want to listen to what the parasha says, because Shoftim comes exactly, usually Shoftim falls in the beginning of Elul, to wake us up, to understand, wait a minute, I have to do real tshuva. And the real tshuva, the hint here, lo tikach shochad, don't take bribery, because the real tshuva, it has to be, first of all, judgment, din emet, has to be emet, truth, and then it has to be shalom. And you know, you have to come in peace, to make peace with people. That's the point of Elul, is that you have to make peace with everybody that chas v'shalom, there's a disagreement. And then Bezad Hashem, you are fulfilling the mitzvah she'olam kayam, that the world exists because of the pillars that you are building in this world. Bezad Hashem, we should have the wisdom and the ability not to ever take shochad, not to take bribery, because the Yetzer Hara not always is looking to make me fail. Sometimes he's looking to make me fail and just taking bribery. Bezal Hashem, we should always have the koach to stand strong against the Yetzer Hara or any other. Sometimes it's not the Yetzer Hara, by the way. Sometimes another person wants to make a forum against another person, so they'll come and bribe you. Hey, let's get together against this guy. And they bribe you and I'll give you front seat here, I'll let you sit next to me. You can hang out with us, just join forces with us against this guy. This is another type of bribery, and needless to say, you use your imagination with all the other forms of bribery. But the Torah tells us very clearly, don't take bribery. Why? Because that's where you're going to fail. That's why the next verse that comes after that, maybe tomorrow we'll learn about it, it says, tzedek tzedek tirdof. You should pursue righteousness and honesty. Why? Because the verse says, lema'an tichyeh. So you will have a real and long life. Person that doesn't pursue justice and righteousness, there's no real life there, and needless to say, brings to a spiritual death. Bezrat Hashem should merit to be met, to be honest and to be pure judges, that we should appoint the right judges to our gates, to our eyes, to our ears, to our nostrils, and most important, to the mouth. What's coming in, what's coming out. בעזרת השם, רבי חנניה בן הקשי אמר, רצה הקדוש ברוך הוא לזכות את ישראל, לפיכך הרבה להם תורה ומצוות, שנאמר, אדוני חפץ למען צדקו יגדיל תורה ויאדיר.